Hey nerds, it's Jared.
Hey guys, I'm Ryan.
And we're talking about So for those of you who don't know who Del Toro is, Blade 2, the Hellboy movies,
yep.
Pan's Labyrinth,
yep.
Pacific Rim,
yep. There's more.
Crimson Peak,
yep.
The Shape of Water, which he just won a whole boatload of Oscars for. And his style is immediately recognizable.
Imagine Tim Burton that came out in the early 2000s. This is what Guillermo del Toro is. He is basically the millennials version of Tim Burton. He should be winning stuff for production design, the look of films, directing and writing. He is killing it. And so we're gonna riff off the top five movies that we think are worth you guys checking out. Starting with Pacific Rim. This is Guillermo del Toro with a budget, with all the money backed into a film. He can talk and bring out all these big monsters, big robots, and just have an absolute fun fest and just make it this massive action blockbuster.
Yeah, but he doesn't forget the people either. So no. He still has those little character moments. It's not a perfect movie by any stretch of the imagination, but it's a lot of fun. There's some great action sequences and monsters versus robots. Who wouldn't like that?
Me, yeah. I love that. Let me in, I wanna watch this 1,000 times over. However, Pacific Rim 2, I'm not sure if you're gonna be as good. I'm watching you. Yeah.
So number four would probably have to be Blade 2.
Blade 2, it's a movie that is a sequel to the original Blade, which was fantastic. Steven Dwarf and Wesley Snipes made an unreal movie, but then usually when you make sequels, they're not gonna be as good as the original. Yeah. Most of the time, 90% of the time, they're usually crap.
Until you get a better director on board.
And you get Guillermo del Toro comes in and makes an absolute unreal movie. And most people, I would say, remember the sequel more than they remember the original film for the Blade series.
He was helped out by a really excellent villain too.
So if you love vampire films, you love Guillermo del Toro, if you love Wesley Snipes and just action movies, Blade 2 was an unreal movie to check out for del Toro's unbelievable directing and production style.
So number three would probably be, I can't pick between the Hellboys. So yeah. I'm gonna lump them both together. Yeah. You need to watch both of them.
Let's just say, just watch Hellboy.
Yeah. Once again, monsters.
Yep.
Awesome production design. Yep. Great Hellboy and Ron Perlman. Also, Doug Jones as Abe Sapien was, I don't know if it was the first time he worked with Del Toro, but they've gone on to work with each other a lot.
If you know who Doug Jones is, Guillermo is the reason why his career started and started taking off in being his character pieces and character roles.
He's in The Shape of Water as well.
So he is.
He keeps using the same people. When
he is the shape in the water, you might say. Number two probably has to go to Pan's Labyrinth. If you haven't checked out this movie yet, then where the hell have you been for the last 15 years? This is the movie that if you've seen any characters or any special effects work for happening in any kind of magazine or even on the internet, it probably came from this film. This is one of the most original and most unique films that have come out since probably the 80s. And it flies into that realm of classic cinema, like stuff like Neverending Story, The Labyrinth, exactly. All those movies that you remember as kids, even Dark Crystal.
Yep.
This film fits in well with it. So definitely check out Pan's Labyrinth if you're an 80s kid and just love classic cinema.
Word of warning though, it is in Spanish, so you have to read subtitles.
Unless you can find a dubbed version.
Yeah, it almost doesn't matter.
No, it doesn't.
Yeah.
You're watching this film for the visual, not for the dialogue.
Yeah.
And number one, obviously, we have to give it to
The Shape of Water.
You can't go past it. I mean, it's a four-time winner for Oscars. It's got Best Director, Best Picture,
Best Original Score, and Best Production Design.
We just went through. If you need to see a movie it's directed by Del Toro and you haven't seen this yet, then we're not sure what you're doing, but check out.
Why are you watching this?
Just check out this movie. You know it's one, you're like, hang on, I've heard about this movie so many times, I just watched the Oscars, but I want to check out something else. Then what are you doing? Check out this movie first. So that's the top five Guillermo del Toro movies that we think are worth watching for you guys to check out. I'm Ryan.
I'm Jared.
And we'll see you nerds at the movies.